Yeah. My name is John Sumner, and I am a self-proclaimed UFO specialist. The region I like to study, or go to, in your words, is Antelope Island. And that is because it is full of alien evidence. And I do believe that aliens do inhabit those lands.
I'm Jeff Higgs. I'm a cinematographer, photographer, all things film, all things images. So me and John go way back. All right, so before we go over any of this stuff or I answer any questions, you need to know that things have changed between me and John. We've been good friends throughout the past and we still are good friends, but things are very different now. He's just doing things and going down a path that is so weird to me, without prodding the dirt, sniffing the ground, trying to connect his soul with the aliens that he thinks exist out there, but I'm not sure they do. He's just changed so much, and I don't really know how to follow him.
My name is Danny Cozine.
And what is your affiliation with John?
Me and John, Johnny Boy as we call him, we've been good buds for the past 15 years.
Okay.
Went to junior high together. Before the events that really changed Johnny's life, I wouldn't say Johnny was ever a normal kid. He's always a little on the weird side. But he wasn't as weird, you know? He was pretty confident. You know, we could get him to do just about anything. He could talk to girls. You know, he's a pretty fun, ballsy, confident kid. But then the incident happened and boy went nuts.
All right, so yeah, we were out at the island. John loves the bison, and there are some bison statues out there, and he asked me for a photo by the bison statue. In the middle of all this, me trying to take the photo, he started pointing. He was like, just kept pointing behind me, and I didn't know what he was talking about. I thought he was just joking about something. So after he pointed a couple times, I turned around to see what it was, and I can't explain what it was. Like a flash of light, but I didn't really know what to think of it. And I still, to this day, don't really know how to say what it was or what I saw, but I saw something. And I saw something.
So the incident, like I said, I don't know much. He's kind of private about it, but, you know, I was sitting at home one time. Actually, I was sitting right here, actually. And all of a sudden, Johnny comes running through my house, freaking out. He's pale. And he says, you know, hey, I just saw some really weird stuff. And I'm like, what's going on, man? He's like, I was at Antelope Island, and I was filming some stuff, and I saw some weird stuff, and I'm trying to get it out of it. And he says he saw some aliens and whatnot. He said he caught it on video. And I'm like, dude, let me see the video, dude. Let me see what you saw. And he wouldn't share it with me. You know, and that's when things got weird, you know. He wouldn't share the video to anyone. He wouldn't really say any details. He started wearing Western clothes. He started to spend a lot of time in Antelope Island doing his little prodding thing, you know, searching for clues. And, you know, after that point, I'm like, I don't know if I can hang out with this kid. He used to be my wingman, and now I don't want him around girls. He's a little weirdo. Oh, that's Johnny right there. I think that's Johnny.
Just sick.
Johnny!
Hey, how you doing?
What's up, dude?
Yeah, it's good to see you.
Been a while, dude. Yeah. How are you?
Good.
Dude, what's going on?
So, I just came over. Would you want to go to Antelope Island with me?
Antelope Island? Are you doing that alien thing again, man?
Well, just look. I'm looking at some stuff. I really think there's a connection. And so, you want to go?
Dude, I don't know, man. I don't know if I don't know if I have time today, man. I got a lot going on.
Okay. Oh, is this the filming crew?
Yeah, dude, we're doing some filming, man. We're doing a little documentary, if you will.
Oh, okay. Yeah, alright. Well, then I'll see you later then.
Hey, I'm sorry, man. I really am sorry.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Hey, take care of yourself, alright? I'm telling you, man, he's weird. He's never been the same.
I don't care if they make fun of me or say harsh things. I've made fun of a lot. Yeah. I got into UFO hunting because I saw a UFO. Now, you may not believe what I have to say, but I saw it, and it flew right over through my vision, through my channel of vision, and I saw it.
So after the experience, I felt pretty weird. Even that night, I didn't get much sleep. The experience has really been playing over and over in my mind, even though I don't know how to explain it. I've taken to research and books about aliens and going to the library often to try and see what other experiences people have had and how maybe those relate to mine. But for now, it's still a big question that I have, and I don't know what to think about it.
Okay, we're gonna go probing out here. All right.
So I saw what John says he saw too, but John has just taken it to a new level that I'm not comfortable with. He probes the earth with a hot dog stick, and you and me, we both know that a hot dog stick is for roasting hot dogs, but he's out there prodding the dirt thinking it's going to send out some vibrations that the aliens are going to respond to, and I don't believe in that, not at all.
And he just probes the dirt back and forth. I saw him do it once, and that one time was enough for me. That boy's never gonna get a girlfriend. The weirdest thing I've ever seen.
So yeah, there's been lots of times when I'm out there doing my work. I'm probing the land for a new artifact. And these people will come and they'll start laughing. They'll start scoffing and pointing fingers. And these people, they don't understand that. So how could they judge me and how can they make fun of me? They don't understand. So I'm okay with it. It's basically what I'm saying when they're making fun of me. But they do it often. And sometimes I do have to take a break from my work. I go get a buffalo burger and sit back and relax. Wait till the people move along.
I'm not going to lie, after this experience and other experiences that I've had in the past, I don't know how to answer that question. Our relationship has changed. And I don't know where it's going.
For the future, I'm going to continue to be vigilant in my searching and my experiences with the land. I'm going to continue to open up my heart to new discoveries. Because a lot of times people, they see the land, but they don't see the evidence that is there upon it. So for the future, I'd like to continue to look for aliens and to continue to understand what they would like to communicate to me.
You know, the more I talked to him, the more real it seemed, the more scared he was. I'm like, this is real stuff. You know, Johnny really thinks he saw aliens.
I think if aliens are out there, and I know I saw something, but why can't they talk to us? Why can't they come talk to me face to face?
All right.
Okay. A little to the right. Yep. Yeah, that's it. Okay. There you go. All right. Yeah.
Holy shit! Shoot, Bill! Turn around! Hurry! Holy shit! Did you see that? What was that? Hey!